My name is Pedro Eustache. Let me introduce myself. For so long, I wanted, and I dreamed. I told you that I'm, you know, of an age, of a time that I would drool at Moogs and ARP stuff. And I dreamt of having a 2600 for all my life. In fact, 20 years ago, I got one and I had to return it because it was so in bad condition, such in bad condition that it was not bearable. Now I have two. Thanks to Behringer. This is sending three kinds of CVs, which is wind. It's sending lip. And then I'm sending, obviously, 1 volt per octave here. Then I have some thing that when I get the threshold from the wind CV, it becomes gate. And the beautiful thing, the modifications that Dr. Matthias Mathis did allows, this is Behringer to do this. It goes directly from one CV to all three oscillators. So you don't have to be patching things independently. And you can see it here. This is the CV thing. You see? That's for all oscillators, all VCOs. And then there's the same thing for the gate. That's his original handwriting and everything. So what this allows is to, for example, if I'm here and I'm using, this is Polyend's preset. Now, if I want to do keyboard style, then I can do, obviously, I can have less of my wind CV actuate and modulate the filter cutoff, and I can have the envelope generator. And I can have a combination. It's like, I don't understand what the detractors are talking about. I really don't. You guys are not paying me for this. You didn't even know that I was doing this. You found out about my machine being with Hans because of a picture that Hans Zimmer Live posted in media. And the beautiful story that we need to get Juan afterwards, that Juan taught me how to tag things. And that's how we connected. The truth is, and I told you this before when we talked, this is part of my voice. I have other things that I use as well. We can probably see them, whatnot. But what I can do with this is very hard for me to do without. So I don't understand, again, what the detractors are talking about when I can have, for less than $600 or around there, a 2600. This is an absolute miracle. And it's incredible. Come here, Musito, come here. You need to come here. This is Juan Garcia-Herreros, Snow Owl.
Hi.
And thanks to him, he is the bass player for Hans Zimmer Live. And thanks to him is that we connected. I was born and raised in Venezuela, South America. I studied in France and Switzerland, but I am in the United States since almost 34 years now. And by the Creator's amazing grace, I am in a strong position in the film music industry by being the main world wins in all the movies. Now we have two that are nominated for Oscars, including Dune of Hans, and we have Encanto as well, and there are many, many, many more. I'm pedroflute.com if somebody wants to see that, or you will tag me for Instagram then. Thank you. The thing is, again, once my friend Juan bought this thing in Austria for me, because I have another one at home, and it was easier for him to get me another one, which he did at a wonderful price. We sent it to Mathis Modifications, and Dr. Matthias did this thing again, which is a super unique thing. But something really amazing that I wanted to show real quick is, let me see if I can do it here. This is really a good thing. I'm gonna open my wind. Check this out, check this out. Are we there? Let me get this a little bit louder for you. Check this out. check this out. Mosito, check this out. This is hard sync, okay? This is that Neanderthal thing I told you, super primitive thing. Listen to this. And if I open this more, a different patch, okay? Now, that is when I do this. So one sound here, one patch, another patch, that, so. Now, check this out. Third sound. Then. Three sounds by just doing this, bro. So they're amazing, beautifully hidden little jewels in this thing, which by virtue of beautiful, abovely induced serendipity. And as I'm playing, I can very easily navigate and have access to so many different patches because I'm busy doing this thing. And I cannot, like you keyboard players, have one hand in the keyboard and do all these things. So these are incredibly powerful, incredible shortcuts that help me when I'm playing live. You can see me navigate and I can have access to many different sounds from basically a very well thought out a patch. Now, the lower part, because I got this wonderful mixer case, I realized that I had space left, and what I did is I tried to expand and complement what I didn't have there, and I'm based on the Synchrodyne WMD, which is an incredibly powerful instrument, completely different in character than the 2600, much more aggressive. Although, check this out, I didn't show you this. Look at this sound. By having the CVs, you can hear, literally, by having different levels of CV that comes from my wind transducer, I have different patches. So this is Hans's. Then I can do this. Out of one patch, by blowing softer or louder, it becomes a completely different instrument. And once I'm playing all these instruments, which I will describe later, to give them a point of reference of where I'm coming with the contrabass, flute, and duduk, and all these things, the beauty of this thing, I feel I'm playing a duduk, or I'm playing a sax, or I'm playing one of my flutes, or a bansuri from India, or a shakuhachi. It is that expressive, it is that precious, it is that incredible. And again, I'm saying all these things, and we didn't have met each other before. You guys are not paying me for this. I paid for this. This is important then. There are other people making 2600s, and I'm not gonna name other companies, there's no need for that. But I know one of them that modified my avatar from the 70s, just a baby 2600 basically. By the way, my Behringer cat is my replacement for that. I got the same gnarly sounds out of that thing. So when I cannot bring a Bigfoot mama like that, I have my cat, and it's just incredible. I love this sound.
It's very gritty. It's
so nice. Bro, this is freaking 2600 Behringer, man, come on. They know that we're in the O2 in London, the O2 Arena. I mean, this is a multi-freaking million-dollar production, and I could not be without my 2600. It's just too precious. That's it. We're not making this stuff up. We're not.
I want to say something.
Please, please.
I want to say something on camera. I've known Pedro for many years, and we have extensive discussions about always finding new journeys, new musical sounds and textures.
Hey, hey.
I've never seen him so excited until he got that 2600. and what
it's a dream.
And what has come out of it.
Exactly.
And also, I have to say that, you know how much, you see his setup, and also with the euphoria and everything that we were talking about. It was so easy to integrate into his setup. And that how do you say that, integratability?
Yeah, of
it.
Absolutely.
I think that is exceptional, so bravo, guys.
Yeah.
Good work.
We had this mixer from 2017, which I'm not going to say the brand, there's no need for that. But Juan told me, Pedro, you're playing at MP3 quality. And since I use the UMC 1820 at home, 2020 was my best year, which was the hardest year for most people in the world. For me, it was my best year. I did 16 movies, including Dune, which now is nominated as an Oscar. And everything I played in all those movies went through my UMC 1820. You see? And this is what I use at home. This is my interface. So all those movies got my sound, my instruments going through this thing, which I got because a DJ from Mexico, Andy Waltman, is the one that got me into that. He calls me maestro. We're doing a project, which I will send you then later. It's an amazing, it's all electronica. So these things are all over this thing. And he, Andy Waltman, and I, working on this thing, he's my young, wonderful friend. He goes, maestro, you gotta check out this euphoria. You're not gonna believe it. I said, man, come on. No, you have to check it. And when I did, I almost fainted. Because I got it from, you know, the store in the States, Sweetwater. And since I got it at home, I asked them to please get one for tour. Somehow, because we have the mixer and stuff, it was set aside. We were not using it until Juan said, Pedro, you cannot play like this. This is not your sound. This is incredible. It's an amazing blessing to me. And then we start, he's asked, can this thing be used as a standalone, not as an audio interface, which we didn't know. So he searched quick in the forums and he found a guy that said, yes, you can use it. So here it is. This is my sound for everything electronic. I have the 2600 here, the Erica Sense. I actually have only two. I reduced it. And then a radio, which is what I use for my oboe that you heard yesterday. Then everything goes through here. This is my matrix. So we're not using it as an audio interface, we're using it as an audio matrix or a mixer, literally. Because I know you got your mixers and everything, but they have only one send or stuff like that. Of course, then you have a plethora of, you know, X32 and all those things. Maybe somebody else crazy like me is interested in something like this, which is extremely practical and extreme. And the, like Juan said, the headroom is, because it's not being taken by anything else on the computer, is pure Midas, and this is my sound. So here, I used for many years point source audio microphones, and they're beautiful and everything. Then, for this tour, I said, let me see if I can try these new Behringer things called the BD440 and the BO440. And then you came to the concert last night. What you heard me play is this thing. This is an amazing, beautiful discovery for me, because based on the positioning of this thing, I love this thing because you cannot beat the price. It's ridiculous. I have eight of them. I have four directional BD440 and I have four BO440s, which are beautiful when things are quieter. But since I'm surrounded by, you know, timpani and drums and stuff, if I have the Omni, other things come in that I don't want necessarily. And with this, what I discover is that, again, it's very obvious, but when you do it in practical, when I want something classical, I put the mic here in my cheek. Then I can play the Mozart section of Lion King, thank you, bro, that you heard me play last night with. But then when we're doing the crazy Latino bump thing at the end, I'm going home, bang. That's the music of my people. And I put it here, so it's like rock and roll direct, super loud. So yeah, so Behringer, and home, cat, second 2600. Juan has the Model D. Come here, you tell what you have.
What I have?
Yeah, oh, what do you have at home?
I have a Model D, Neutron. Pro One. I use the headphone mixer. I love that thing. All my sessions, my string sessions that I record, we use P1s for monitors, for click.
So we were Behringer artists without even freaking knowing.
Oh, and the MIDI foot controller.
Oh,
of course, the FCB. FCB 10, that was great thing.
So there, Dan, maybe we can get you off the stage and talk about other things. For the show, for the record, Dan from Behringer, Dan Burton, you are the first person allowed in our stage to do this. So we're honored to have you, my friend.
Oh, it's a privilege.
God bless
you. Thank you, Pedro.
We can't. Bah! Yes.
Bravo, Pedro.